Hey guys, and welcome back to Doom. Today we play the Equinox map pack with the psychic weapon mod.
Ooh, interesting.
Nice.
And that menu was broken.
Yeah, it was. That's usually it wasn't broken, it's the same version.
It looks pretty complex.
Yeah, this is Equinox.
Yeah.
Let's start by finding some secrets, yes?
What weapons are these then?
These are pistols, so...
Yeah,
you can
I
see
that they're pistols, but...
The sounds kinda come from Devil May Cry, like... Cause most of them kinda come from Devil May Cry. I can't recognize all of them, actually.
Okay, so the guns are original, they're not stolen from some other
no,
game
No,
or
the original sprites may like say, it actually looks pretty cool. You know, when you're not busy making terrible wads, he does pretty cool stuff.
Yep.
Yeah. Like some dynamics, and this is very cool. Very cool weapon mod.
Some dynamics is debatable.
Oh, and the map pack is not made by Xazer, doubt. It's made by D. No, BPRD. That's his name.
Aha.
Here we start finding enemies, and you see that they drop money.
Yeah,
wow, red orbs.
Red orbs.
Just like in the America, except you have to. Explicitly work over them and yeah.
Okay, money so what armor. You're throwing some white.
Yes, so you have the thing with this stuff. Weapon mod is pretty awesome. You have so weapons with infinite ammo, which is pretty nice. And you have your psychic power, we use your psychic energy, bottom right.
Mm.
And with money you buy new powers, you upgrade your powers and weapons, and you can even buy some powerups.
So do you recharge that psychic energy stuff, or do you have to pick up some ammo?
No, it recharges over time if you're not attacking.
Alright.
So if I'm attacking with my guns, it doesn't recharge. Which is pretty sad, actually. So you can just switch between the two, but that would be too easy if you could just, do that.
Yeah.
So here, obviously, we have to go and press switches to open this door. Here's your stuff.
Oh, it does remind me of the Bioshock.
That's... Except you don't have to change weapons with the psychicity. You just use a single fire.
Okay.
Like, you can't really see that right now, but bottom right, you see there's a bunch of little boxes. Like, you know, the item selection thing. Because that's how you select your powers. You just change the item, you press use item, and that change your currently power. And you just, use it with second fire.
Okay, so it was like Bioshock 2.
I never played Bioshock 2, so I can say. Possibly.
It's meh.
Yeah, that's why I didn't play it. Because I know it's that good. And I didn't want to play it for that. So we got a shotgun now, and it looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's nice animation. It's not that good of a weapon, though, which is pretty sad.
What? A shotgun in Doom, that's not that good of a weapon.
Yeah, damage is. And spread it has a huge spread and not the damage you would expect. Like, even fully upgraded, you take two shots to kill a demon.
No. So, upgrade and buying stuff, can you do that from anywhere?
Yes, I just have to press a button and you see the menu appear. I've been doing that not too long.
Yeah, because you can use it in any map pack, so it will be kind of hard in shops.
Now, actually, it's a pretty good menu, made pretty well done. It's that's why I like this mode, it's just well done. Maps are pretty good as well. Textures, map layouts are pretty good. Some new sounds, replacement for like enemy sound and stuff.
Yeah, Xavier's supposed to be a pretty good scripter from Rifford.
Yeah, Xavier's pretty good at scripting and it's pretty good at writing too. Actually, it's not just Xavier that made this. I should. Go back and check the credits, I will post that in a thread.
Ah, right.
Yeah, I didn't do that alone, of course.
He's really bad at jokes, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hopefully this doesn't have any jokes, just weapons.
Yeah.
Actually, I just lied, just jokes, because it changed the messages when you get killed by enemies and get items and stuff.
Oh.
So every kill message got changed, it was like pretty bad. Like, if you got killed by a sergeant, it said, "Oh, hey, they saluted the wrong sergeant."
Mm. Oh.
Brilliant joke.
I like good bad jokes, but not bad bad jokes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
At least it's not too much out of
it. let's never speak about that again.
Yeah. I mean, I still remember when I see Spangus Avada. It's only a good part.
You're welcome, Spangus.
So for now, we don't have much weapons, just two weapons and one power-up. I'll be buying all powers during the game. I still have my favorites though. So blades, they're okay, but they're cheap. They don't do terribly good damage.
Yeah.
So I won't be using them much after I start getting playing the first powers. And so that was the intro level. So that's kind of important to remember because we'll be seeing it again. This map pack has a... It's not a up level, just normal maps, but it feels like it's a up part. Like this level here. It's a teleport station. We'll be coming back here a few times. And all every right. time going to a different location.
Right.
So it's a hub without being a hub. So you don't get lost, have to find puzzle keys just in it.
Yeah.
I don't really like
that. Jump a stupid tower to find some switch to...
Oh, yeah. Oh, I'm missing the item.
Oh, you got hit in the stomach.
Yeah. Oh, here's a kind of map of the complex, could say. So, we have to go to three locations. Storage, labs, and hangar.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, here's the hardest secret in the game.
Yeah.
Oh, quite a challenge. Tough well one. Done.
So, I find this as a weapon mod and... this map pack to be pretty good combination.
Yep, sure looks like it.
You see later on, it just fits, I think. One of the map pack that really fits it is what's the name of it? Eternal. Like it's a megawatt, 32 maps. But I won't play this. It's the maps are too big, too mazy. I keep getting lost and I can't find all the secrets. Too effort. I tried playing the maps and finding all secrets, but it's a really big effort. They're fun to play and they would drag on. So yeah, that's a problem with Eternal. But they're good maps, looks very good, and good ambience, and so on. So yeah, time for the shop.
Alright.
So I've just...
So you got five guns.
Yes, total. Five guns. So there's no point in buying the guns you can, because you find them. You shouldn't buy
them. Oh, right. But you should buy power.
Yeah, but the powers though, you can't find them. You can find a specific item that let you grind one of your powers, which is very rare. Like it replaces a PFG, I think. But every power you have to buy. It's actually a big number of them, and they have some specific effects.
That's pricey.
And yeah, stuff. And you can buy items. So it's like stuff like elf armor. Map, double damage, stopping time, regeneration, guard sphere, pretty much everything, the map. You can even buy a thing that lets you see the enemies on the map, just like IDDT cheat code.
Oh, so this is like double
damage. Yeah, basically, yeah. The only problem is that you can't, the game is not paused when you look at the menu. But what you can do now is bind two keys for quick buy, like I'm going to do here. Quick buy, elf, quick buy. Stopping time, why not? I'm actually going to use this once. And I just bought lightning. Second power. So yeah, just...
Lightning squid.
It doesn't seem that good, but it's actually pretty nice. Does pretty good damage and spread out to nearby enemies. The spread is kind of bad at start, but you graded it just... It's really good. Not as powerful as some other powers, though. But easy to use, and it's a very important point, you can't kill yourself with it.
Oh, right.
Yes. Oh, and something to talk about in the items, there's two items that are specific to the mod. One is like called Overcharge, which overcharge your psychic powers. It puts your psychic energy to 200%. And as long as you're over 200%, you can... Yeah, all your powers are extremely powerful, they have special effect.
Sounds sweet.
And most of them make your weapons, like just like the Tome of Power in Heretic, all weapons much more powerful for a limited time. Yeah. So here are the stuff that's in this mod, we'll be seeing pretty much everything over the 13 maps. Yes.
Yep. Yeah, that shotgun does seem weak.
Yeah, you can notice I just have trouble killing stuff, and the spread is huge. It's just spread everywhere except on what you're aiming at. Oh, and this part's a bit annoying. It looks cool, but at the Lost Souls and shotgun guys, you can't even see.
Yeah.
And money, that's too far to
get. Left side. I'm looking at that nice chart down there of your persona.
Actually, yes. The
you can see it turns red in the stomach when you get shot and stuff.
Yeah, that's.
And it goes outside the monitor frame. Yeah.
Actually, the HD is from the mod, from Psychic, but how do you call this? The face, the face replacement is from Equinox. Normally, you would have a Doom guy with sunglasses. and on Eternal, you have a guy that looks like a time traveler. Oh, and Lightning, sometimes he can one-shot the demons. And you call it to max, if you have a big bunch of demons, it's going to kill all of them in one hit.
But
Lightning very graded is much inferior to every other power if enemies are not very bunched together.
Right, so you have to line them together.
Yeah.
It does seem kind of crap right now, though.
Yes, the blades are not going to use them at all. Like, you guys give more blades, but the powers are far awesome.
It seems okay if you can line up your shots.
Yeah. So yeah, I just went back here just because I wanted to get some money from the enemies in the way. It's time to go where I'm supposed to go. Yeah, money. Yes, money everywhere. So it's different, like money thing, like 1, 5, 15, 20, 25, I think, 50. And even 100. You drop different like money. Like, you know, Hell Knights and bigger enemies drop bigger stuff and so on. And that's normal. But if you kill enemies with specific power, usually like imps and zombies, they give more money when killed. Just bonus type, I suppose.
The effects of the the power seem kinda lame though.
Lightning is the one that doesn't look very good. I mean, upgraded it looks better because you see lightning spreading, but basic is just not very
expensive.
Yeah, those powers are better in Sean. I just took lightning because it fits this level. You have a lot of imps and demons and enemies that can easily be killed.
Yeah.
The best part about lightning is you're going to see that when I find my first overcharge. You see it's awesome.
Looking forward to that.
For now, it's Mace section.
Mace and Doom. Can't say they've ever been fun.
I mean, this one's not too bad because it's not too big and you get items. And since I get money from King Demons, I just don't mind. Yes. One thing of the Beast Altar, I have to spam click to attack. I can't hard, just click.
Well, I usually spam click even though I don't have to.
Yeah, that's
just used to that for some reason.
The Schengen, but this is different because there's two like player classes that got changed in one of the versions of the slide sheet. Like at first you could only do a click, and then he added a player class that could hold button to attack.
Different.
But when you do that, you fire sword and you just add the spam click one. So just get the spam click for that.
Oh no. Your right arm is damaged.
Now, one thing about psychic powers, when you get like almost no power and you try to use psychic powers, you take damage.
Oh.
And if you're empty and you try to use one, you die.
Oh, that's very nice. Whoops. Thank you, Xavier.
Caesar. Not Xavier.
Xavier, sorry. Oh, I don't care.
So, can you actually cast them with your health or? Does it just fail?
No. I mean, you can cast like when it's very low, you can cast like one more time and take damage. But if you cast when you have no thing, you don't cast. You just take shit ton of damage.
Okay. Ooh, golden coins.
Oh yeah, ammo spawns are replaced with, obviously, with money.
Yeah.
And the thing, yeah, notice that this map doesn't have much ammo, and that's why I don't get much money. And I never played this without with normal weapons, so I don't actually know. Except that the maps are pretty balanced, except two last ones. And we got first overcharge, like you can see bottom right that our energy is white.
Yeah.
That means we are 200.
Quad damage.
And we also have like bars on the top right that let us see our time on the power-ups. It's boosted the dial.
Okay. That's a bit more effective.
Yeah, air boost lightning is pretty much like BFG. And the boosted blades just have four or three, I can't really see, homing blades that just fly around. It's pretty awesome, it doesn't use much energy, so you can use that against big enemies.
Alright.
Lightning is much better, but use ton of energy.
Are you sure they home though? They just seem to be bouncing around.
No, they're actually home, but they're home and bound, so it makes a mess.
Right.
Doors closed and it's
gonna be the old Unreal Tournament days.
It doesn't bounce like that, like you saw no one just keep falling all the time.
Yeah.
UT ones just go forward.
Well, it was an alternate fire and a ricochet bounce fire.
Oh yeah, miss explosive discs.
Yeah. And then you got decapitation or something.
Yeah, you could get headshots with no more fire. Oh, here you're going to buy second power fire. So here, actually, you can get a bit confused. The boosted fire, actually, what it does, it makes fires appear all around you. And it does very good damage. Like, fasted claws would have killed everything here. And no more fire from the fire power-up. Just do a burst of fire and spread out like that.
It hurts you.
Doesn't seem very effective, but actually, if you have like enemies like Barons just walking toward you and you just throw two of those as a fit, it kills them very quickly.
Okay.
It's pretty good. It's not the best.
I can see the use.
It's good. Oh, and now it's time for backtracking. You remember that that Megasphere at the start?
Yeah.
Yep, so here's one secret I had a bit trouble to find, but I'm going to find eventually. I know it. It is. That's very obvious, but here we go. And I'm going to need this Megasphere for the start of the next level.
Alright.
Oh, and Chimpunk.
Wow, it's very hectic music now.
So yeah, this map, like, I kind of like the look too. It looks like tech, but a specific kind of tech. So the guy that made the mod made a pretty specific look and
sound and stuff. Why not?
Yeah, it kind of fits. And I guess the story would be that, like, instead of having demons, they just got genetically like made or something. You see like banks of arms and stuff.
Eye bottles.
Yes.
Fetuses, eye bottles.
Oh, and yeah, you see a fire death from Ames here. Like, and he drops money of different color.
Oh.
Alright. So cool, that's the end of the first video, I suppose.
Whoa.
Next time we're going to share the Genome Lab. Yeah, it's already done. Well, that's quick. So see you next time.